Hey everybody, we're going to do a quick little demo of something that Rob and I actually demoed with Chi and Tara about a month and a half ago at a conference. It's basically using Google Plus Hangouts in conjunction with a VST plugin and software that you'd normally use to record to allow it to record peer-to-peer and still communicate over the Hangouts while we're doing that. So Rob can still hear me and talk to me over his microphone, but it doesn't affect his guitar signal going into my rig. So what we're going to do is I'll do a screen share of what it looks on my end. So you can see I have the Hangout window beside me. And for the purposes of this demo, I'm doing this on my MacBook Pro because it really is a mobile setup. We have a template saved for the session that literally takes 2 seconds to call up, and it's ready to go, record arm, done. So we're just going to give a little demo of how this works, essentially. So, Rob, take it away.
Just do a little playing?
Yeah. So I'm not rerouting the audio back into the Hangout because that would cause some issues, but as you guys can see, Rob, when he's playing guitar, you have the meter. Now I can actually record arm this and track this at the same time. I can do this. Actually, I'll zoom in a little bit here. The follow. And then Rob, stop playing and talk.
Checking 1, 2. You'll notice my microphone audio not drawing waveforms in Lucas's DAW, but the guitar does. How about that? Maybe. Is it there? There it is. It's just slower, making the round trip.
Oh, there we go. I'll green box this. Yeah, so let's do that again. So basically, Rob, play and then stop playing and then talk, and I'll be able to see it a little better. His playing guitar comes in just fine. And this is basically a VST that you're adding in the channel strip. You can see here.
Right, on the master bus here.
Yeah. He's adding it on the master bus. You can add it on an individual channel if you want. We're going to start getting kind of crazy with this and doing multi-channel streams. So think of sending a left and a right, and then, you know, it's all just bandwidth limitation. And then when he stops playing and he starts talking, you don't actually...
Only the guitars make it to Lucas's studio, or to his DAW, his version of Ableton Live. My microphone is not, and that's good news.
Yeah, because, I mean, the whole idea is to allow real-time collaboration between artists and, you know, a session player and a producer, for instance. The way that it's done up until now is you basically bounce down the song, or the demo of a song, email it to them, have them send it back. This way, I can send it over Dropbox, and hopefully when the Google SkyDrive comes out and that's all integrated, we'll just start using that. And, I mean, I can already imagine how seamless it'll be.
Right.
And, yeah, that's pretty much it.
What's also really great about it
is
I was just thinking, take a scenario where you're all recording directly to that through the Hangout. Each of you could do your own cues through the microphone, and it wouldn't affect, you know, the audio track that you're playing.
Exactly
so
right.
Make recording very, very efficient in a way that you wouldn't have to worry about timing so much. You'd just be like, guitars, go.
That's the real cool thing about this setup is that it solves a problem where recording studios want to record a session player that's not geographically there. We don't need to have asynchronous jamming. We just need to be able to communicate, and I need to be able to hear what Rob's adding or subtracting from something in real time, so I can say, okay, change that lick there on bar whatever, and he doesn't have to go in, re-record the take, re-email it to me so I can hear it in context. I can just have him record and dump it in the session, and I can demo it. So for purposes of just songwriting, I think it has pretty big implications. Oh, sorry.
Absolutely does. And in this way, the Hangout really is only functioning as a window connecting our studios. This is what we're talking to, just like a normal Hangout, would we?
I think that Rob and I are the same mind in this one, where we want, from our own perspectives, to take the studio experience and make the glass on your laptop no different than the glass that separates us in a studio. Normally, Rob would be on the live floor, and I'd be in the glass behind that in the live room, or in the control room recording. And there's no reason, except for bandwidth, really, that can't be a reality on a computer as well. So it's, you know, this is baby steps to getting there, but this is a pretty big one that took me quite a while to figure out how to actually make this make sense and it be flexible. I mean, it's really, really easy. That's the main thing that I came across with trying to figure out a solution for this, is that for musicians to want to use it, it has to be easy for them to use and to recall it very quickly to get those ideas down. That's pretty much it. I'll end the video right here just because I wanted to make it pretty quick. If anybody has any kind of questions about the logistics of it, you can comment on the video after the fact, and then we can kind of get a dialogue going back and forth. But I just wanted to do a quick demo of it, and I think everybody gets the gist of what we're trying to do. And it's going to be something that we keep iterating on. Like software developers, we're just going to keep making it better and better, and it's going to get more seamless. And that's pretty much it.
Definitely.
Thanks, y'all.
Yeah.
Cheers.